This one is a bit tricky, to be honest. I'm not 100% sure of what this is. Let's look at it together. Well, the size is relatively large. This is my finger in comparison, so it's just a relatively large mushroom. Perhaps the most striking is that the cap is is full of little spikes. These are not scales, but really spikes. This type has a ring as well, and the ring is going down like a skirt. The gills are free. Only a few genera share this. Lepiota, Amanita, Pluteus, and Agaricus. The fact that you have a skirt ring, white gills, free gills, makes me hesitate between Amanita and Lepiota. Lepiota usually have a ring that can move, and that is not make like a skirt, but really like a ring. So, in fact, this species look very much like a cousin of Amanita rubescens. Amanita rubescens is an Amanita that gets red, or a color of wine. It was called Amanita vinosa in the past. This one is a variety that is much less red, that has more like this brown color, but that has very spiky hat. It was also called Amanita franchetti in the past, and you can find it also in forest a bit more in altitude. Very much Amanita franchetti, and nowadays called Amanita aspera. Amanita aspera, very likely Amanita aspera. It seems that it has been even renamed as Lepiota. This Lepiota aspera.
Smells a bit like burnt rubber. Not fantastic smell, you will say, but fresh burnt rubber. Ah, doesn't make it any better. This one is supposed to be tasty. Only when well cooked. If it's raw, it's very toxic, just like Amanita rubescens. However, I wouldn't dare to try that, even me who knows mushroom a little bit. So I will not recommend to try this one, because there are so many confusion possibles with Amanitas that are very toxic. Amanita or Lepiota aspera, first time I see that.